I've been given a slot by the INEC, so no more going to court. Peter Obi reacts after he was asked if he's still taking INEC to court for a review of election results. Okay, my people, I'm back once again. Like I told you before this very broadcast, that a broadcast I just gave right now, Peter Obi actually made this comment in that very broadcast. But this is a full download of that very comment. Peter Obi was in an interview, and he was asked questions by Nigerians. He was asked, what is he now going to do? What is his next line of action? What will he do now that he has been denied of his right? What is his next line of action? Peter Obi went straight forward by saying that, well, I will not take that route again. You understand? I'm not taking that route again. Though it was in the past. I really wish to, because I felt cheated. But because they have owned up and given a slot, definitely I will pipe low and let go. Now, in the comments section, some person reacted, calling Peter Obi all sort of names. Let me quickly check some of the comment sections before going into the content itself. This is Toju. Toju said, "Fool, after making us to waste our time fighting for you at the polling unit." That's what Toju said. The other one said, "Do you know some people are still fighting for your sake? Now you are turning them down." But then, if I may ask you, my listeners, does this really come from the heart of Peter Obi? Let's check the content. This is Evening News. The Labour Party presidential aspirant Peter Obi, that has just lost the election, has actually answered correctly before the INEC officials. According to him, "The election has come and gone. I've lost, accepted, but no going back." Peter Obi meant by that statement, he said, "I am coming back to recontest, but for this one, I've given up. An offer has already been made. The INEC already have accepted their wrongs. They know that what they did was wrong, but let it be. I am willing to let go, provided they meet up with their promise. I am returning back in the next 4 years, but this time definitely will be different from the other one." Peter Obi has pleaded for calm, asking all to allow peace to reign, because peace is what we call freedom. I gave a broadcast, I think the second broadcast I gave this very evening. Some women, as we speak in Anambra, has gone naked in protest for a review of Peter Obi's results. People are busy fighting for Peter Obi. Peter Obi is at the front, giving up. You see? And that is why when people like Obi Kubano and other people are fighting for Peter Obi, I say, please, my people, hold your peace. Because you don't know the person you are fighting for. What about those people that have died for his sake? A lot of people died for the sake of Peter Obi now. Don't you know? People died at the polling unit. People were born alive for his sake. You see, that is why when I said it before the election itself, I said it that it is good to vote, but be mindful of your voting. Be mindful. Where you saw that there is violence, come back. Forget the voting. Save your life. Look at the lady that was beaten in the southeast. She was beaten to pulp. She was beaten to the extent that one of her eyes went blind. After beating this lady still came back to come and cast a vote for Peter Obi. Everybody saw the lady now.
Everybody saw her. They made her the hero of the election.
Oh my God. This is disappointing. Very, very disappointing.
Yes, it's disappointing to see.
Peter Obi wouldn't have taken this. He wouldn't have taken this move. Notwithstanding, we are still there. We don't know how true this is, but I'll say let's just stick for our hands and keep watching.
Alright. The deed has been done and also has been said. Let's hear from you, my dear people, and let's know what you equally think. Don't forget your comments. They are still very much of great importance. Don't forget to leave them below the comment section. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated each time we upload any new videos. Thank you.